I think it's a very new type of diving that not a lot of people know about yet.
I really jumped at the opportunity because it's something that's not done very often. We're diving with almost no light or very, very little light, and that is even more challenging.
I scan the water with flashlights first to make sure there's no obvious things like jellyfish on the surface or something like that.
It occurs all the time, but it's best to see at night. And what's happening is these marine creatures are absorbing light at one frequency and emitting it at a different frequency. So to capture that, you actually have to excite the marine life with a certain type of light, and you actually have to remove that light before you film it. So what we've actually done is experimented for a long time on figuring out different ways of capturing this, and that's probably why you don't really see this very often, because it's not easy. It's uncharted territory right now. We're discovering ways of capturing it. We're discovering things that fluoresce that we didn't even know about. And we're experimenting with different ways of getting the best images.
We are finding new things that we had no idea fluoresced underwater. What we're searching for now are even more things that are fluorescent that no one has even had any idea about. It's very rewarding to be able to go underwater at night and be diving in very difficult situations and really low lighting situations, not knowing if we got it or not. Well, next, I think that we're going to try to get over to Asia and see what's fluorescing over there that no one knows about yet, and get some incredible photographs and maybe make some even more incredible discoveries.